Ed Courtney presents Aspects of Opera.
Good evening, and you're all very welcome to Aspects of Opera. And tonight's opera is Don Giovanni by Mozart, first performed in Prague, 1787. The main characters we'll hear are Don Giovanni, a young nobleman, an extremely wicked and licentious young nobleman, baritone; Il Commendatore, the commander, bass; Donna Anna, his daughter, soprano; Don Ottavio, tenor. He's engaged to Donna Anna. Donna Elvira, soprano, a lady of Burgos, and deserted by Don Giovanni. Leporello, bass, sidekick to Don Giovanni. And Zerlina, soprano, a peasant girl. The elements of this story can be found in the folklore of many countries, even Iceland. The probable sources of the Don Giovanni or Don Juan saga have been the subject of much speculation by an army of scholars, but that's not important. What is important is the character study of this rapscallion of noble birth, this odious character, the sort of person people pretend to hate, but in fact secretly admire. We see the type at parties, at work, in clubs and so on, surrounded by admirers, or sycophants might be a better word, Leporello, his servant, being one prime example. Don Giovanni is a hedonist, a pleasure seeker, but above all, selfish. He cares nothing for the feelings of others. But it's, I suppose, his unconquerable egotism that in the end leads to his downfall. Il dissoluto punito, the rake punished, is yet another title for Don Giovanni. Such tidbits of information are interesting, but what really matters is the fact that a story dating back to Spain in the 1500s had to lie almost dormant until the most famous collaboration in the history of music took place, that of Mozart and Lorenzo da Ponte, the librettist. And from there, the story in the shape of an opera took full flight. This opera, I could even call it a music drama, has remained since its first performance one of the most popular of all the operas. But first, very briefly, the plot. 17th century Seville. The extremely licentious Don Giovanni, aided by his servant and sidekick Leporello, tries to seduce Donna Anna, but is disturbed by her father, the Commendatore, whom he kills in a fight. Donna Anna and her fiancé Don Ottavio swear vengeance. Giovanni's attempts to seduce the peasant girl Zerlina are foiled by Donna Elvira, whom Giovanni has seduced and abandoned. All turn against Giovanni at a party at his villa, but he escapes and finds refuge in a cemetery, where the statue of the Commendatore comes to life and speaks. Light-heartedly, Giovanni invites the statue to supper. The statue arrives and drags the unrepentant Giovanni down to hell. Don Giovanni, the hero villain, is destroyed by the statue of the man he has killed. Let's listen to more of this overture, which is in the so-called French form, a slow movement followed by a fast one. It begins andante with much of the material drawn from the final. And why not? Mozart only wrote what we're listening to the night before the final rehearsal. Listen and enjoy. First, let's hear Donna Elvira, a lady of Burgos, who has been let down by her lover Giovanni. Ah, chi mi dice mai? Oh, who can tell me now? Don Giovanni, the opportunist, overhears her anguish and makes his move, but the lady is not the forgiving type. When you listen to the soprano voice of Donna Elvira, bear in mind the huge range required for singing this aria. The so-called chest voice is required, which is the lowest register in the singer's range. the resonance gives the sensation of notes being lodged in the chest. The orchestral accompaniment consists of pounding chords for the soprano. Can you hear them? Intensifying her anguish. Having heard that, compare the more lyrical, seductive accompaniment Mozart gives to Giovanni's air later on. Giovanni tells his servant Leporello to come clean and tell the lady that she's not the first and won't be the last. He advises her to listen to this honest fellow. Then she might understand. He quietly slips away, leaving the stage to the Elvira and Leporello. The catalogue aria, or Madamina, Little Lady, is to me the finest piece of craftsmanship in the whole opera. Listen to Leporello's descending voice, answered by upward arpeggios in the strings. Later, the flutes, in a series of rising seconds, urge his bass voice upwards to a climax. Handel did the same in the Hallelujah chorus. This aggressive approach is contrasted later by a more lyrical tone, when Leporello tells her that he's even courted the elderly, referring to Donna Elvira herself, for the pleasure of adding her to his list, which goes into thousands.
Madamina, il catalogo è questo, delle belle che amò il padron mio, un catalogo è che ho fatto io, osservate, leggete con me, osservate, leggete con me. In Italia 640, in Alemania 231, cento in Francia e Turchia 91, ma in Spagna, ma in Spagna son già 1003, 1003. mille e tre ma fra questi contadini cameriere cittadine la contessa e baronesse marchesane principesse e bandone d'ogni grado d'ogni volle d'ogni età ogni età in Italia 640 in Almagna 231 100 in Francia in Turchia 91 ma in Spagna ma in Spagna son già 1003 ma fra queste contadine cameriere cittadine contesse baronesse marchesane principesse e bandone d'ogni caso d'ogni forma e d'ogni età ogni forma d'ogni età
Spagna, 1003. In Spain, 1003. What a guy. Act 1, scene 7. Zarlina and her boyfriend, Masetto, sing with a chorus of villagers on the pleasures of love, a country dance which is celebrated in the orchestra. I'll forgive you if you're reminded of Beethoven's pastoral symphony here. Listen carefully. You'll hear the horns in F. That's the pastoral key. La ci darem la mano is a duet written for Don Giovanni and Zerlina. Here the nobleman persuades the country girl to leave her boyfriend and come away with him. Don Giovanni is about to ruin the young girl's life. He's even promised to marry her. Musically, his aria is joy itself. Ba 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 bum bum ba bum. She responds with the same melody. Mozart then blends both voices together, phrase, counterphrase. At last, they sing in harmony to show that the union has succeeded. Don Giovanni will surely get his way. No. Luckily for Zerlina and her boyfriend, Donna Elvira, the lady with a grudge, steps in and foils his attempts. But now, Donna Anna, the poor girl whose father, the Commendatore, has been killed by Don Giovanni, cries to her fiancé, Don Ottavio. Not only did Giovanni kill her father, but he tried to rape her. To me, this is the most powerful aria in the whole opera. If I could term this a concerto for voice in the classical sense, I would. She calls for vengeance on her father's killer. Or soy chi l'onore. Ottavio, hurt and saddened, tries to comfort her in her anguish. His aria contrasts markedly with Donna Anna's. Long, deep chords in the orchestra bear along his tenor voice. This gives way to a gentle rhythm. Your ears will now be torn between the magnificent aria and the magical accompaniment, Dalla sua pace, on her peace of mind.
Thank you.
At last, the forces of goodness are beginning to combine together against Giovanni. So he responds in the only way he knows, throw a party and get everyone drunk. Remember, Giovanni is a hedonist, and so far his true character musically has not been evident. Mozart gives him this aggressive aria to show his true nature, and here it is.
Finché non vino callo la testa, la festa fa preparar. Se trovi piazza qualche ragazza, tengono quella cerca menar, tengono quella cerca menar, cerca menar, cerca menar. Senza una nella fissina, chi mi tu, chi la follia, chi la lavana, para velar, chi mi tu, para velar, chi la via, para velar, chi la lavana, para velar. E di frattanto alla secanto, con questa quella, vuoreggiar, vuoreggiar, vuoreggiar. Alla medista, una mattina, la regina deve aumentar. Alla medista, una regina deve aumentar. Se non piazza qualche ragazza, che con quella cerca meno. Alla medista, una mattina, la regina deve aumentar. Se non piazza qualche ragazza, che con quella cerca meno. Chi la follia, chi la domanda, para meno. Alla medista, una mattina, la regina deve aumentar. Una regina deve aumentar. Una regina deve aumentar.
Here in scene 3, act 2, Don Giovanni is again putting the moves on Donna Elvira. Does he ever give up? I hate to say this, but at this point of the opera, you begin almost to admire the guy. I think Mozart did too, because he represents the very antithesis of the composer's life. Not many ladies can resist a sort of troubadour with mandolin singing a little canzonetta like this and calling her to the window. Could you?
Vieni alla finestra, o mio tesoro, vieni a consolare il pianto.
However sweet the present, the past comes back to haunt him, literally. In scene 15, the statue of Donna Anna's father, the Commendatore, speaks to him. The casual Giovanni invites him to supper. Now, the idea of the living dining with the dead frightened the wits out of people then. A heavy knock on the door is heard. Mozart at this point strikes like a thunderbolt. The whole orchestra, including trombone, seems to blare out bom, 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 right into Giovanni's face as the statue strides in with the words, Don Giovanni, you have invited me to sup with you. I have come.
Oh!
Giovanni tries to brazen it out. His courage still holds. Repent, demands the statue. Never, replies Giovanni. Never, old fool that you are. They bandy their yes and no for a while, till the statue, as a great hush comes upon the orchestra, abandons the unrepentant sinner to his fate. Your time has come, it says, and disappears. We'll take it from the point where Don Giovanni accepts an invitation to sup with the dead commendatore. He accepts the grisly invitation. The statue demands his hand in pledge. An icy cold creeps through Giovanni's veins. The invisible spirits cry out for his body. He finally breaks down. There is a final come from the spirits, followed by a tortured ah from Giovanni as he disappears forever to everlasting hell. I'd like to end tonight's programme on a happy note, an aria of love. Don Ottavio's concern for Donna Anna is felt here in one of the tenderest melodies in the opera, Il mio tesoro intanto. Meantime, go and console my dearest one, and seek to dry the tears from her lovely eyes. This aria is very much a dialogue between clarinet and tenor voice. Mozart loved the clarinet. So, until the same time next week, good night.
che sol di stragi e morti, occhio poi io torna.
Aspects of Opera was presented by Ted Courtney and produced by John Hughes. Next week, Opera is The Tales of Hoffmann by Offenbach.